Welcome, my name is Ryan, and you are watching part one of my 2017 RecyclerView tutorial. In this video, I'm basically going to be giving you an overview of the project, which will include an idea of how I like to teach, a rough diagram of the software architecture, a quick demo of the application, and also a message at the end. So that's all, and let's jump right into the demo. So the application that we'll be building to begin with is simply a very basic recycler view. We'll be adding to it as the tutorial series progresses, but for now, this is exactly the application I will be teaching you to write. So how this basically works is we have this recycler view, which is full of a whole bunch of list items. And what you can do with this app is you can click on a given item in the recycler view, which will take you to a detailed view of the activity. Now, I'd like you to notice that the detailed view of the activity has the same background color, the same string, which is basically just a date and time, and also a little message. And those are the same as the item which was clicked on, which is the point of that whole thing. So if I do one more here, you'll notice that it's yellow and so forth. Also, another thing, just really briefly to note, is that when I change the orientation of this application, please do note as well that at this point it doesn't save application state. You'll notice how it changed color, and let's change it back one more time. Whoops, let's try and do that a little bit better. There we go. And I'll hit back. So basically the point I'm trying to get at here is this data is actually randomly generated in a fake class. So I've given you a demo of what the app does at its current point, and this is the app that we'll be building. Now what I'll do is give you a really brief overview of the software architecture of this application. So basically how this thing works, see if I can get this to a reasonable zoom level, there we go. Basically how this thing works is we're going to have two different activities, a list activity which actually contains the recycler view, and we'll also have a detail activity which is of course the detailed view of the list item which I showed you just a moment earlier. The detail activity is going to be kept very bare bones. We will do some animation work later on, but this one is deliberately not had a lot of effort put into it, so just be aware of that. However, unlike a lot of tutorials, I will actually be putting a lot of effort into showing you how to build this recycler view properly in the context of something similar to a real application architecture. Now, if you're a beginner, that's a whole bunch of jargon words and concepts that you're probably not familiar with. That's totally fine. I'll be taking you through the whole thing. But just to begin with, I've basically set it up so that our list activity is going to be talking to a controller, and this controller is going to be talking to a fake data source. I'll explain what these things are later. This isn't even really a specific pattern, so to speak. But what I'm trying to demonstrate is simply just that we can divide our architecture into three distinct layers a lot of the time, and we'll see what the benefits of doing that are. For this application, the primary sort of data model that we'll be working with is just a thing called list item. You'll notice that that's a very bizarre and vague name, and that is very deliberate. What I'm trying to do is sort of give you an idea of what these things might look like, and then when you start working in your own applications, you can kind of fill in the blanks as you go. And last but not least for the software architecture, since I'm such a big fan of test-driven development, I'll actually show you how to write a really simple unit test class, and by no means an exhaustive unit test class, I'm just gonna kind of get your feet wet with it, for this controller. And what I intend to demonstrate is that by writing this little test thing and also learning a little bit about unit testing, we can actually see how these tests can help us write the rest of our application. So that's basically it. The next thing I wanted to discuss is my teaching style. So there's a couple things I wanted to mention. To begin with, a lot of my viewers are either beginners or ESL or both. So you will notice that I try very hard to use very little jargon, and I'll only use jargon if I'm giving you something you might want to look up later, or if I really feel like the situation calls for it. Also, I happen to be a fairly working class dude, so that is the way I talk most of the time. Secondly, I will take as much time as I like to explain what I want to talk about. I go on tangents. I deep dive into random minutia. The next video is probably going to be quite long. If you don't like that, or you don't have the time to watch what may end up being a 45 minute to an hour and a half video, that is your problem. You don't have to watch this. And lastly, and this is something really, really important to me. So I mentioned this briefly in the software architecture thing, but I will be trying very hard to teach basic fundamentals of app building as I show you the RecyclerView itself. Now, that might be a little frustrating to some of my more advanced viewers who just want to sort of figure out how to slap in a RecyclerView into their application. Well, the thing about this is, A, all of the code is going to be hosted open source on GitHub. So if you just want to figure out how to do this quickly and you want to put on the daddy pants, then my suggestion would be to just go look at the code and don't watch the tutorial. However, since a lot of people watching this will be beginners, and I know this based on the feedback I got from the previous RecyclerView tutorial, I'm going to be trying really hard to help you in app building in the general sense. So that's that. There's only one more message I have. So if you're the type of person who just likes to get everything for free and doesn't like to give back to other people, then I hope you enjoy the video and you can ignore this next message. However, if you're the kind of person who realizes that I might have put a very large amount of time and effort into this free content, then please be aware that I have a Patreon page. And if you would like to consider donating even $5, which is probably the equivalent of a cheap or an expensive coffee drink at Starbucks or something like that, then please do consider donating at least once a month. I really do need money so that I can improve my equipment and living situation. And while I'll continue to release most of my stuff for free, that would really help me out. Now, if you're in the position where you really don't even have $5 to send to me or something like that, or if you can't support me financially, that is totally okay. Not a problem at all. I understand very well what it's like to be in a position to not have a spare $5. So if you are in this position and you would still like to help me out, you can do me a favor by hitting like on the various videos, sharing my content, and leaving comments if you would like. So that's that. That's basically it. I think we're going to have a fun time with this series, and I've put a lot of effort into showing you how to build a RecyclerView, not just well, but in the context of a real application. Thank you so much, and please enjoy the following content.